Hello dear friends, in the previous lecture we came to know about voice. What is mean by voice? What are the types of voice? And then according to tense form, how the voice is changed. That can be that were already done in the last lecture. Now in this lecture we will come to know again the same point, same topic, that is voice, but here the sentences will be different. We'll see how imperative tense is changed over here, how imperative tense is performed, sentence is performed, sorry. So what is mean by imperative over here? So imperative basically is a sentence which start with verb and ends with object. Okay, let us see one example over here. Just a minute. See, it is one example of active voice. Verb and object is there. Okay, verb and object. Here, change the voice is the sentence. Verb is the change, and the voice is object. Okay, so what is the sentence? Change the voice. See, this sentence is started with verb. So whenever the sentence starts with a verb is called imperative sentence. See how it is changed in passive voice. See, the formula of active voice is verb and object, but it is little bit different. Let, we have to write first of all let, then after object, this object has to be put here, then after we have to write be, and then V3, third form of the verb. See how this is, has been changed here. Let the voice be changed in this way. Let, then after this object has been put here. After that we have put be, then this is the verb which is in first form, and this is the third form of the verb. So how the format of the sentence, how the sentence has been covered. Let the voice be changed. This is the sentence. Let us see again another examples. Again, our examples dekhenge. Pehla example dekhte hai. Give a glass of water. Now it is also verb and object. Give is the verb. A glass of water is the object. Now, as all you know, the format, please write this format for imperative sentence, verb and object. And let plus object be plus V3. Please note down this. Now, see. Give a glass of water. Let a glass of water be given. Let is the starting word we can call. After that, we have to put the object. What is the object? A glass of water. Let a glass of water is the object. After that, be has been put here. And what is the verb? Give. Third form of the verb give is given. So give a glass of water has been changed as let a glass of water be given. So in this way we can change this sentence from active to passive. Now the second example, let us see. Make a beautiful picture. Now make is the verb and a beautiful picture is object. How this has been changed according to this format? This is the only one format where which is we are going to applying let. This is let. After that object, what is the object? A beautiful picture. A beautiful picture. After that be, and then after made. So just a minute. Here we have applied this format. Now give him some money. Now in this sentence there is a slight difference. In this sentence there is only verb and object. Verb and object. Here one thing is what you call added. Ek cheez jyada hai, wo hai him. So agar aisa hai, agar ye what you call the we can call it a remaining sentence. So verb and object is there, or ye word hai, this word has to be put at the end. and it will be followed by to. See how it has been changed. Let object some money. Be give becomes given after that to and him. So let some money be given to him. That is the answer of this sentence. Now after that, let us see another one example. Give everyone food and water. Now give is the verb, food and water is the object, and everyone is the remaining part of the sentence over here. See, let after that object food and water be, then after third form of the verb given, and this is the remaining word, that is to everyone. So in this way you can change this this sentences in imperative sentence by using imperative sentence from active to passive voice. Now again we are going to focus on another type of sentences. First of all, we have seen imperative sentences. Now just now we saw what we call the imperative sentences. Now interrogative sentences are there. So there are two types of interrogative sentences. अगर interrogative sentence की बात करें तो इनके दो types है. दो टाइप्स है, कौन कौन से है? पहला जो टाइप है वो है WH. जस्ट अ मिनट. ओके, पहला जो टाइप है वो है WH है, ये WH. और दूसरा WH वर्ड्स, WH क्वेश्चन ऑलवेज स्टार्ट विथ WH वर्ड. जैसे कि फॉर एग्जाम्पल व्हाट, वेयर, व्हेन, हाउ, हु. ओके, जैसे कि फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेट मी अटर अ सेंटेंस फॉर यू. वेयर आर यू गोइंग? हु आर यू? हु इज गोइंग टू प्ले द क्रिकेट? When will you come here? Such type of sentences are WH question, where the answer is specific according to WH. And the second category, this is the first and second category of the question is verbal question. Now why they are called verbal question? Actually they are also called as no type question. Okay, verbal questions are also called yes no type question. Verbal questions are actually there are they start with two verbs. The first one is auxiliary verb and helping verb. So auxiliary verbs are can, could, may, might, would, will, shall, like this. And helping verb, if we talk about helping, actually these auxiliary verbs are also helping verb, but those specifically helping verbs are there, the is, am, are, was, were, and do, did, does, have, has. These are helping verbs. See how these are functioned in another sentences. Let us focus on that too. Interrogative sentence. पहले एक एग्जाम्पल देखेंगे, बाद में बाकी के एग्जाम्पल्स देखेंगे. सो यहाँ पर एक सेंटेंस है, देखो, कैन वी मैनेज द इवेंट. इंट्रोगेटिव सेंटेंस का एक ही मतलब है कि जहां पर सवाल पूछे गए हैं, ओके, कि जिनका जवाब देना है. ओके, सो कैन वी मैनेज द इवेंट. सो कैन इज हेल्पिंग वर्ब और वी कैन कॉल इट इज ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब. जस्ट अ मिनट. Can be called helping as well as auxiliary verb over here. So can is also auxiliary verb. After that, subject is there, we. Manage is the verb and the event is object, then question mark is there. Now what we have to do? Agar aise sawal puche gaye hai ki jo helping verb se start ho rahe hai, सॉरी ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब से स्टार्ट हो रहा है, कैन, कूड, मे, माइट, ऐसे, विल, वुड से, शॉल, शुड से, तो जो वर्ड है वो एज इट इज लिखना है, जैसे कि आप देख सकते हैं कैन है यहाँ पर भी, कैन से स्टार्ट हो रहा है सेंटेंस, इट इज एक्टिव वॉइस एंड इट इज पैसिव वॉइस। तो मैं यहाँ पर ए लिख रहा हूँ, ये एक्टिव वॉइस है और ये अपना पैसिव वॉइस है। सो कैन वी मैनेज द इवेंट, तो कैन का कैन एज इट इज लिख रहा है बिकॉज इट इज ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब। आफ्टर दैट हमें लिखना है ये हो गया अपना हेल्पिंग वर्ब ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब। After that, we have to put object. What is the object? The event. The event को इधर लाओ. Can the event? After that, we have to write be. तो be यहाँ पर लिख दो be. After that, third form of the verb लिखना है. यहाँ पर कौन सा verb है? Manage verb है. तो manage को इधर लाओ. Manage का हो गया managed. ed लगाया है इसको क्योंकि इसका second form जो है वो है managed और third form भी है managed. So manage and managed managed. So after that, we have to write by and then this subject has to be put here, that is us. We becomes us, I becomes me, you becomes you, they becomes them, she becomes her and he becomes him. You all know this, that is why I'm not going in that much detail. So now our sentence is, can the event be managed by us? After that question mark is there. I hope you are getting me. Please write all these, please write this formula. This formula, this is for active voice, this is for passive voice. Okay, let us move on to the next sentence. पहले हम ये सेंटेंस जान लेंगे कि ये एक्टिव है कि पैसिव है. डू दे सेल द बिल्डिंग मटेरियल, ऑब्वियसली इट इज एक्टिव वॉइस, इट इज एन एक्टिव वॉइस. डू दे सेल द बिल्डिंग मटेरियल. नाउ वॉट इज द फॉर्मूला, वॉट इज द फॉर्मैट? एच वी, दैट इज हेल्पिंग वर्ब. यहाँ पर कैन है, ये हेल्पिंग वर्ब है पर ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब है, ये प्योर हेल्पिंग वर्ब है. तो डू दे सेल, ये टू डू, मैंने फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर में बताया था कि टू डू के फॉर्म्स है डू डीड डज. ओके, जैसे टू बी के है इज एम आर वाज वर्ब, टू हैव के है हैव हैज हैड, ऑल 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 वर टोल्ड टू यू एक्चुअली. सो दिस इज टू डू, डू. Do they sell the building material? Do is helping verb, they is subject, sell is verb and the building material is object. Now, see here. Now, as you are looking at do, do is there. Just a minute. Okay, there is do. Now, whenever we write do, it means it is present tense. अगर ये did होता तो past होता obviously. So do है इसलिए इसका helping verb हम do नहीं लिखेंगे, इसका helping verb लिखेंगे हम is. Are you getting my friend? अगर यहाँ पर भी जैसे for example अगर यहाँ पे होता building materials तो ये are बन जाता. क्यों? ये इज क्यू है बिकॉज बिल्डिंग मटेरियल नॉट बिल्डिंग मटेरियल्स. ओके, नॉट बिल्डिंग्स. ओके, एंड मटेरियल्स, नो, मटेरियल इज देयर. एक्चुअली मटेरियल मटेरियल्स नहीं होता बट ओनली सिंगुलर इज देयर, दैट इज व्हाई देयर इज. सो इज इज और हेल्पिंग वर्ब. द बिल्डिंग मटेरियल इज और ऑब्जेक्ट. सोल्ड इज द थर्ड फॉर्म. After that we have to write by and then after we have to write subject and at the end we have to put question mark. So is the building material sold by them? Dekho bhai, do ka is ho gaya. After that we have to put object. Ye dekho, ye apna format hai, helping verb likh diya. Object kaun sa hai yahan pe? Building material hai, ye building material likh diya. Uske baad mein be lagana hai. Just a minute. Okay, let us continue. देखो ये जो बी जो है, this बी has to be used. Just a minute. This बी has to be used only with auxiliary verb. Okay, only with auxiliary verb. जैसे कि can है, could है, may, might, shall, will, would, should. This be has to be used only with auxiliary verb. Can, could, may, might, shall, should. Okay, not with helping verb. Helping verb के साथ नहीं इस्तेमाल करना है be. That is why. Let us see again. Is the building material sold by them? This is the answer. So, what is the format? Again, see, helping verb, उसके बाद में object, उसके बाद में ये है अपना V3 sold, उसके बाद में है by, उसके बाद में है subject, उसके बाद में है question mark. So, HV, helping verb, object, V3, by and subject. Okay, so is the building material sold by them? That is the answer. Let us focus on another sentence. Okay. Did you understand the lesson? Did is the helping verb. You is the subject. Understand is the verb. And lesson is object. Okay. So, was the lesson understood by you? Now, why there is was? Yahan par do tha, yahan par is hai. Are you getting me? यहाँ पर डू था. डू मीन्स प्रेजेंट, इज मीन्स प्रेजेंट, डिड मीन्स पास्ट, वाज मीन्स पास्ट. सो डू रिप्रेजेंट्स द प्रेजेंट, दैट इज व्हाई देयर वाज इज. डू जो है वो प्रेजेंट रिप्रेजेंट करता है, प्रेजेंट टेंस को रिप्रेजेंट करता है. दैट इज व्हाई हमने यहाँ पर डू के जगह इज लगाया था. अभी डिड जो है वो रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है पास्ट टेंस को, तो इसलिए हमें हम लगा रहे यहां पर वॉज. सो लेट अस सी, डिड वॉज, डिड का हो गया वॉज. आफ्टर दैट हमें क्या लगाना है, ऑब्जेक्ट लगाना है. ये ऑब्जेक्ट डिड द लेसन. आफ्टर दैट V3, अंडरस्टैंड का V3 है अंडरस्टूड. सो वॉज द लेसन अंडरस्टूड बाय यू. यू का यू ही होता है इसमें पैसिव में, जैसे कि वी का अस हो गया, दे का देम हो गया, पर यू का यू ही होता है. दैट हैज टू बी कीप इन योर माइंड. So, यहाँ पर be नहीं लगाना है. If there is do, did, does, no, be has to be used. Okay. Let us focus on the next sentence. Now. Okay. There is another one. ये अभी हमने एस्नो टाइप क्वेश्चन वाले देखे. Verbal questions, sentences have been over. Now we will focus on WH question. When do they open the gate? Now this open, this tense format, you have to keep in mind one thing. Let me tell you. Just forget this for a moment. Okay. ये जो part है red मैंने किया है उसको थोड़ी देर के लिए भूल जाओ. Okay, थोड़ी देर के लिए हाथ रख दो वहां पर ऐसे. Do they open the gate? इसका क्या हो गया? Is the gate opened by them? ये जो हमने अभी जो सीखा है इसके पहले की स्लाइड में, ओके वो है. अभी वेन आ गया यहाँ पे, तो यहाँ पे भी वेन लिख दो, खत्म काम हो गया. ओके, अगर ये वेन को हम थोड़ी देर के लिए ऐसा पूरा निकाल देते हैं, ओके समझ लो. डू दे ओपन द गेट, इज द गेट ओपन बाय देम. ये हो गया अपना हेल्पिंग वर्ब वाला सेंटेंस, वर्बल क्वेश्चन. ओके, whenever we put WH before that, it becomes WH question. So let us see, when do they open the gate? When का when as it is लिखना है, WH का as it is लिखना है, when है when लिखो, where है where लिखो, why है why लिखो. सिर्फ एक ऐसा word है कि वो है who का by whom लिखना पड़ता है, otherwise all the things are same, all the words are same. When do का हो गया is, क्यों? क्योंकि ये present है. After that we have to use this object. After that open जो verb है उसका V3 format use करो. After that by use करो. And after that they का हो गया them. Okay my friends. So when is the gate opened by them? This is the answer. When is the gate opened by them? Okay. Next is, who discovered America? Now in this sentence, focus on, Who is WH word? Discovered is the verb which is in second form. Yes, इसका मतलब है past है या clear है. America, that is object. Now, who becomes by whom? As when becomes when, but who becomes by whom? ये एक ही है who जिसका by whom होता है. Otherwise, all the things are when, where, why. Okay. So, who becomes by whom, what's क्यों आ गया अभी? यहाँ पर तो do, did कुछ नहीं है. Because ed है, discovered, past, v2. My friends, focus on that. It is v2, discovered. That is why there is was. Who, by whom, was. After that, we have to put object. ये हो गया wh. ये हो गया helping verb. Object put करना है. America, America. Okay. So, America. And V3 that is discovered. यहाँ पर subject नहीं है. यहाँ पर हमें by them by XYZ by Amerigo by Vasco da Gama वगैरह कुछ नहीं लिखना है. No Columbus वगैरह nothing. So by whom was America discovered? That is the passive voice of who discovered America. I hope you are getting me. Now these are some of the examples. Some of the examples in the left side, my left side, you can see active voice. Sentences are in active voice and these are the answer in passive voice. Please make a screenshot of all this and try to analyze at your home. Now these are some of the exercises for you. It could be your assignment. Just take it as your assignment and write down all these. Get the screenshot and write down all these questions, sentences, and just change them into passive voice. Friends, we learnt in these two lectures. The first one was with assertive sentences where tense forms were there and we changed them from active to passive. After that, the second one was there. That was interrogative. Sorry, third was interrogative and the second one was imperative. Now, after all this, if you have any query regarding voice, how the voice it's changed from active to passive, you can ask me in the comment box or in our WhatsApp group also or classroom also. With this, we stop here. Thank you very much.